Hey there, if you are someone who usually runs out of time when exam is about to end, like me, you must be knowing what it means to get extra time to complete your exam successfully. And what if you are getting this extra 30 minutes in your AWS exam? This is no hack, but a real benefit provided by AWS. Welcome to my channel SkillPhilip, and let's try to understand how to add extra 30 minutes in your exam. This benefit, which is also called as ESL plus 30 minutes accommodation, is available to non-native English speakers when taking an AWS exam in English language. And this request gets automatically confirmed and is applied to all of your future exams. But how can I request for this extra 30 minutes for my exam? All this can be done in just 3 steps. I will show you the demo how to request for this ESL plus 30 minutes in this video. But let me tell you, you won't be able to apply this accommodation if you have an upcoming scheduled exam. But don't worry, if you still wish to apply this benefit on your current exam, I have discussed this step ahead in this video. So stay tuned! And now let's have a look at their website. So I have logged in into my AWS certification portal. And now let's go to my AWS certification account. So this is the place where you'll be actually scheduling your AWS exams and doing much more with your AWS certifications. So click on the upcoming exams tab. Then click on the request exam accommodations button. So here you don't have any accommodation requested yet. So let's request the one. Click on this request accommodation button. Okay, so on this page you can see some notes regarding the ESL plus 30 minutes that you must apply for this accommodation before you schedule your exam. We will discuss about these notes in this video after this demo. So select this drop down and find the ESL plus 30 minutes option. Click on this option and then click on create. So as you can see, the ESL plus 30 minutes option has got already approved. So this was just few steps to request for your ESL 30 minutes. And now for all your future exams, this plus 30 minutes will be automatically added with your exam time. So on the certification portal, as we can see, we found two important notes. And the first is you must request for your accommodations prior to scheduling exam. And this ESL plus 30 minutes benefit is available to non-native English speakers when taking exam in English language. And also this benefit needs to be requested only once, and this gets applied to all your future AWS exams. So this was somehow discussed earlier in this video. Now let's get into the more details of these benefits. So firstly, make sure you have already logged in into your AWS certification account, the same account or the same place where you will be scheduling your AWS exam. And the language for the exam should be English to avail this benefit. And as we discussed earlier, you should do this before you schedule your exam. And if you have already scheduled your exam but you want to avail this benefit, then follow these steps. First, cancel the exam. Request for this accommodation and then again schedule the exam so that this accommodation gets applied on this exam. And as we saw in the demo, it gets automatically approved when you submit the request. And in some few cases, if it is not automatically approved, wait for the AWS to respond and provide them any documentation or information they might request you. And in case they are taking too long to respond, you can always reach out to their helpline to raise your concerns. But this happens in very few cases. So that was all about how to request for extra 30 minutes in your AWS exam. Please hit that subscribe button so that it helps me to create more such videos for you. And don't forget to press that bell icon so that you stay updated about my latest videos. Please click on the like button and do share this video with all of your friends. Thank you so much for watching, and all the best for your AWS journey.